welcome class 7. Myself Shabana Musa, I'll be teaching you English. So today we'll start with the topic nouns. Now if I ask you to define a noun in one or two words, what will you say? Yes, noun is nothing but a naming word. So let us see the definition of a noun. A noun is a word which names a person, place, animal, thing, or even an idea. Now, let us see the examples one by one. Now, person. For example, Tina, or we may say teacher, etc. These are the names of person and hence they are called as nouns. It can also name a place. So a place can be a name of any country like India, or it can be name of any city like Mumbai, or it can be name of any small place like classroom, etc. Now let us see examples of animals. You all are familiar with the names of animals, isn't it? Like tiger, lion, cat, dog, etc. Noun is also a name which is given to a thing. For example, car, book, pen, fan, etc. So the name which is given to an idea is also called as a noun. So ideas like we can say happiness, justice, truth. So the thing which we cannot see or touch, just we can feel. So the names given to these things are also called as noun. So have you understood what is a noun? Noun is nothing but a name given to any person, place, animal, thing, or idea. Now let us move ahead. We'll learn about different kinds of nouns. There are five kinds of nouns: proper, common, collective, abstract, and material noun. So now let us talk about all these kinds of nouns one by one. So first we will start with a proper noun. What is a proper noun? Proper noun is a name given to any person, place, animal, or thing in particular. So it is a name given to particular person, particular place, particular thing. For example, John. So John is a proper noun. There may not be many person whose name is John. So if I say John, means I am talking about someone particular. Or January. So there are 12 months. If I say month, then it will not be a proper noun. But if I specify the month, name of the month, that is January, then it is a proper noun. India. So there is no other place which is called as India. India is a name of a specific country. Hence, it is a proper noun. Taj Mahal. See, other monuments or buildings cannot be called as Taj Mahal. So Taj Mahal is one particular monument. So it is a proper noun. Then it can also be the name of a river like Brahmaputra. So all these names which are given to any person, place or thing in particular, then it is called proper noun. Remember children, proper noun always begins with a capital letter, whether it is used in the middle or at the end. So it always begins with a capital letter. So let's move on to common noun. Now what is common noun? It is also a name of person, place, animal, thing, but in general. Common noun is a name given in general. Here I said proper noun is a name which is given in a particular, and common noun is a name which is given in general. For example, girl. So there are so many girls. So I'm not talking about any particular specific girl. I'm talking about a girl in general. I can say there was a girl at the gate. So which particular girl, we are not specifying that. Hence, it is a common noun. Actor. So I love this actor. Which actor? Here also I'm not specifying. It means it is a common noun. Likewise, man, architect, poet. So these are all common nouns because I'm not giving any specific information about that particular noun. So we are talking here about these nouns in general. Hence, these nouns are common nouns. Now let us see what is collective noun. Collective noun is a noun given to a group. So it may be a group of person, it may be a group of animals or any other group which acts as a whole. So the group which acts as a one whole, it is called as collective noun. For example, swarm. A group of bees is called a swarm. Then a group of wolves is called a pack. A group of soldiers is called an army. A group of singers is called a choir. A group of ships is called a fleet. So, collective noun is nothing but a noun which is given to a group. Okay? Now, let's move towards abstract nouns. Now, abstract nouns are the nouns of our feelings, emotions, or state of being. We cannot see or touch these nouns. We can just feel it, and hence they are called as abstract nouns. For example, happiness, kindness, truth, wisdom, death. So these are all our emotions or our feelings or a state of being. We cannot see or we cannot touch these nouns, and hence they are called abstract nouns. Next is material noun. Now material. Material means a substance, right? So a material noun is a noun which is given to a substance from which other things are made. For example, plastic. So I can say a bucket is made of plastic. So plastic is the material which is used to make the bucket, and hence it is a material noun. Or I can say gold. The bangle is made of gold. So the gold is used to make the bangle, and hence gold is a material noun. Wood. The bench is made up of wood. So wood is the material which is used to make the bench, hence wood is a material noun. So dear children, have you understood different kinds of nouns? Different kinds of nouns are proper nouns, common nouns, collective nouns, abstract nouns and material nouns. Okay, let us move ahead. Classification of nouns. Nouns can be further classified into two types, that is countable and uncountable. Now, what do you mean by countable nouns? Countable nouns are the nouns which we can count. For example, I can say one pen, two chairs, three tables, five fingers, etc. So the nouns which we can count, they are called as countable nouns. Countable nouns can be either singular or plural. For example, pen is a singular noun, pens is a plural noun. Cat is a singular noun, cats is a plural noun. So countable noun can be either singular or plural. The next is uncountable noun. Now what is uncountable noun? Uncountable means which we cannot count. So the noun which cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. For example, little water, some rice. So see here, now water, can we say one water, two water? No. Rice, we can say one rice, two rice. No, we cannot count it, right? So these are uncountable nouns. Or we can say money. Can we say one money, two money? Can we count money? No. We can count rupees. We can say 20 rupees. But we cannot say 20 money, right? So the nouns which cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns, and nouns which can be counted are called countable nouns. I hope you have understood the concepts. Thank you.